Hello friends, and thank you so much for taking your valuable time for checking into this topic. In this video, we are going to talk about what is target population and what do you mean by accessible population in research. Okay, to begin with, for carrying out any research work, be it at an undergraduate, postgraduate, or a doctoral level, the first priority in research is identification and selection of the research problem. And to understand or find solution to the research problem, data collection can be carried out either from the population or from a fraction of the population. So with this, let us first see what is population and in its time with respect to research. Okay. In research, when each and every element or individual present in the group or items of interest to the researcher are included or incorporated for data collection, then this is referred to as population. Okay. So population, as another synonym of population in research, we now use is the term universe. So by definition, population is an aggregate of all the observation of interest to the researcher. Okay. So population can be of two types. One is the finite population and the other is the infinite population. Let's take an example to understand finite population. Let's say the number of students who have been awarded PhD degree from JNU or Delhi University in the year 2019 and 20, the number will be finite, isn't it? But if I say the number of students who have been awarded PhD degree from all the university all over India in the year 2019 and 20, that will be an infinite population of the PhD degree awarded. Okay. Now in research, there are two types of population that needs to be clear right from inception, and they are target population and accessible population. Let's see what is a target population. Target population, as the name suggested, is the population that is targeted by the researcher for data collection. And therefore, target population is a type of population where the entire group of individuals or element is being taken into consideration for the study. Whereas, what is an accessible population? Accessible population is referred to as the selected group of individuals or element from the target population. To simplify this, okay, let's use an hypothetical example. Let's say the researcher is interested in conducting a study on the reasoning and IQ level of PhD students from the state of Assam. Okay, so in this study, who will be the target population? The target population will not be schools or colleges present in the state of Assam, right? The target population will be all the universities that are present in the state of Assam. For example, this university can be either a central university or a state university or a private university. So for this study, target population will be the universities that are present in the state of Assam. Okay, now let's see what is an accessible population. From all the universities that are present in the state of Assam, let's say three universities were selected from the target population for the study, and they are Assam University, Guwahati University, and Royal Global University. And these three universities selected from the target population will represent the accessible population. Okay, I hope with this example, you will be able to understand the difference between a target population and the accessible population. Okay, what are the different benefits that we obtain if we study the entire population? So the benefits are, since each and every element in the population are being studied, the idea or the information about the population obtained will be complete. Okay, And also the data or the information or the conclusion drawn will be accurate and reliable. Okay. However, there are a few drawbacks of if you study the entire population, and they are, it is time consuming. Okay, because you have to study the entire population, it takes a lot of time. And data collection might also be inaccessible or not feasible, because it could be because their population size is very, very large. So it'll be quite difficult to collect information from each and every element that is present in the population. And next is be the, okay, the method of collection of data from the population is a costly method of data collection. And also, more manpower and resources is also needed. This is the reference that I use in this presentation. And with this, I would like to say thank you so much. And I hope you'll be able to understand the difference between a target population and an accessible population. Thank you so much for your attention once again, and God bless.